Welcome back once again to the Tropicana Resort and Casino on the Strip in Las Vegas. Joel Myers along with Michael Jonick. The piece of the floor is down to the floor with our interviews. And Daniel Dock hot early. It continues. Ralph Hahn very quiet recently, but still not that far behind. Well, Neil Jones, Joe Scott on the back end, have to pick it up because the blinds are up. Last hand, they just moved up. Our chip girls to the left, Melissa, Erica to the right. And they remind us the blinds are at 3,000 and 6,000.
Neil Jones is in the big blind, 6,000 of his short stack at risk before the cards are ever dealt.
See one folds, see two folds, see three
and
folds.
I predict Mr. Jones is going to want to play his hand, but he is going to be dominated by the short the small blind Russo.
About the pot.
18,000.
Jones might feel he has to take a stand here.
And he is gone.
Note that Russo did not show his cards, and Neil Jones did.
The partner law firm we've been talking about, a poker face, keeping the glasses on, and here's a guy who's not been showing his hands at all. He's taking things very seriously. And Andre Russo, well, he'll know to do with the chips if he wins.
I am a tax attorney. It would be great to win the $25,000 here at the Poker Dome. So I would try to work with it so that the government would get the minimal amount that they're required to get. Hopefully I move on to get the $50,000 and then subsequent to that get the $1 million. So it set me up for retirement pretty well.
No shock. He's a Cav guy and his favorite athlete. It's LeBron James. Good news for Cleveland fans just a few weeks ago. A couple of weeks ago, LeBron James decided to stay in Cleveland.
15,000.
Speaking of athletes, our semi-pro quarterback, Neil Jones, has picked up another big hand, Ace King.
And you talked about Doc showing his cards, maybe to set up for a possible bluff down the road. He's got suited connectors, but on the low end.
Jones is all in.
See, one fold. 22.
Doc is compelled to call. He already has a whole bunch of chips in there. It only costs about 9,000 more to win a 43,000 chip pot at the time, so he's getting good odds. And as you see here, although the ace-king is a lot prettier than the 9-8 suited, in this case, they're pretty close.
Club. So now, the potential of an inside straight for Doc. Even though the odds aren't in his favor, he got the jack.
Now, you know what? That made the Broadway straight for Jones. Jones has
Jones
the best
the
hand.
Higher straight. You got it. Jones was fooled like we were on the turn. But
I was.
What a hand.
I was just waiting on you to outdraw me.
I was too.
Yeah.
The jack.
So Jones thought he was about to get up.
That's as crazy as I'm going
to
get.
He was ready to depart the premises. What a break with the higher straights.
Jones has now returned to his original chip position of 50,000. And Doc once more has come back to the field. Jones getting hit with a deck. Another big hand. Pair of nines.
Is it time for Joe Scott?
Oh, yes. And it's terrible timing. He only has one live card, the ace. This is going to be an easy call for Jones. Joe Scott is going to be looking for an ace.
Ace nine.
All the other nines are out.
You're looking good. Good luck, buddy.
Daniel Dock, next door, happy to be out of it. King, 10 and a 5.
I'm hard. Yeah, you want to hurt.
On the turn, any help? Not for Joe Scott.
Well, Scott can counterfeit Jones if the 10 pairs, and he can win with an ace. Doesn't happen.
So the first to lead. Joe Scott, it looked like it was going to be Neil Jones. Last hand, all of a sudden, Jones picking up more chips. And Joe Scott, the 26-year-old from Altmar, New York, is the first to be eliminated. come right back. ImaginedPoker.com. Poker Dome Challenge continues. Count to five.